Hey, welcome back! Today's challenge is to paint different leaves using the same watercolor background we created in the previous video. The first thing we are going to do is to group all the layers. Let's rename the group so we know what's in it. Duplicate it. And turn off the visibility of the bottom one. We are going to paint a Xanadu leaf, so let's change the name of this group. No idea what a Xanadu leaf is, right? Well, until yesterday I didn't know its name either. Anyway, if you need a reference photo, just go to Actions, flip the reference switch, and a floating window will appear above your canvas. Tap on Image and finally import your reference image. We can move the window by dragging it from the top. Make it bigger by dragging it from the corner. And we can rotate it and zoom in to see the details we want to copy. We can do this using the usual gestures. This leaf is quite simple to replicate if you are not aiming for a realistic painting. So I think we are not going to use it this time, but there it is, just in case you want to use it. I forgot to tell you that you can also use the eyedropper tool to select any color from the reference image. So cool, right? Well, where was I? Oh yeah, we were transforming this monster leaf into a green Xanadu leaf. Let's open the group then and turn off the visibility of this layer to make it green. Now go to the bottom layer. We need to choose the same color we used to paint the Monstera. Yellow in my case. And we are going to pick the masking fluid brush because it is completely opaque and it has a rough edge. We will start erasing the top, so tap and hold on the eraser tool to use the same brush. Basically, we will be switching between the eraser and the paint tools to create the new leaf. We can increase the brush size to get a rougher edge, see? If we make it smaller, we will get a smoother edge. I like something in between. Just like this. Let's continue erasing in fast mode. Okay, this is almost done. Let me just finish the bottom leaflets. Now, let's switch back to the eraser tool and paint some extra veins. That's it! The silhouette of the new leaf is done. Now, we just need to blend the paint a little bit more here and there. Tap on the watercolor layer. Let's start fixing this part. We can blend paint using the blender brushes if we want to add water and get a more dramatic result, or we can use the same brush we used for painting the washes. In this case, I want a smooth transition between colors, so I am going to use the water ease of edges, but with the smudge tool. We will also get different results depending on the brush size, the pressure applied, and the movement. Try making circular movements, zigzagging, tapping repeatedly on the screen, etc., etc. It will not look the same if we use it as if it were a stamp. Then if we drag paint this way. See? In this case, I think it looks better if I just tap a few times. How is it looking? I think we need to make the paper texture stand out a bit more. So let's create a new clipping mask, rename it, choose black, go to watercolor papers, apply the texture, and finally duplicate the layer. Let's zoom in. Yeah, much better. Now we can export it the same way we did in the previous video. Bye-bye background, go to actions, and don't share, export it as a PNG. In this first example, I modified the silhouette of the other leaf because I want them to be alike. But we can also get rid of the silhouette and start from scratch. Let's do it. Duplicate the group again. Rename it. And turn off the visibility of the group underneath. Tap twice on the layer in which we painted the base color and then clear it. Now choose any brush you want. I will use again an opaque brush. Remember that if the base layer is not opaque, your clip art won't be either, okay? In this case, I will use black to paint the stem, and yellow again for the leaves. This brush is pressure sensitive, so making the leaves is quite easy. Just start with light pressure, increase the pressure progressively, then decrease it to make a pointy tip, and finally go down, varying the pressure too. As the watercolor paint on the clipping mask is not opaque, we will see through the colors we apply on our base layer. If you are using a darker color, your leaf will be darker than mine. Well, it also depends on the color you chose for the colorful watercolor layer. I can't wait to see how your leaves are looking. Don't forget to tag me at LettieBlueIllustrator if you post it on Instagram. In the next tutorial, we will use our leaves to make a seamless pattern to use on products and also a simple pattern brush. See you there. Bye.